Hey guys, how's it going? It is I, the real Randy Chavez. I'm coming at you today with an Earth 2 update video. This has happened a couple of days ago in late May, I believe. But I'm addressing it now because the only person I've seen address it is My Name is Human Podcast, link down below. Oh, well, hello, you're back. How did it go?
I'm good. I'm
ready. You're awesome, Eddie. All right, so this is a question and answer with Wolfgang and Nathaniel and Shane. Everyone's in here. So. One of the questions was, how can a guy with 8 million subs just post a video called Another Massive Scandal with zero research? It's wild. And Nathaniel says, yes, YouTubers copy each other. Another question is, he's basically reacting to others' videos. Yes. Nathaniel says, yes, I mean, they want each other's videos. So one of his arguments is that it won't render. But the funny thing is that it does, and even half-optimized, it renders very well. This is going to be a long one, guys. Yeah, and while the attention is good, it's not... While the tension is good, it's sad not more gameplay and work can be out already to show them more what to expect in the future. But I mean, we mods will take care of the social media. Hope you devs can find some peace in all the chaos at work. Nathaniel says, yes, but we're working on it. Also expanding the team and making good progress there. We have all the terrain physics working now. Terrain and stones, trees, trunks, etc. All updating on the fly when modifying. While the YouTube video has absolutely no research, I do agree that barely any proof of the development that the devs constantly talk about is being shown, and none of us can actually know for sure if Earth 2 is actually making good progress, or if it still is a glorified version of Google Maps, and considering people have put hundreds of thousands of dollars into this project, I think they deserve to be a little bit more informed. Nathaniel says they have a point, but then we've just released for 6 months, started with a very small company, and we've grown a lot already. So he's kind of just saying, give us time, guys. We're 6 months old. Is the video recorded yet? Nathaniel says, I'm working on it. Not recording yet, but getting all the stuff in for showcasing, waiting for some ramps from Ferran to make cool jumps. People saying drone was abandoned. What happened to drone? Nathaniel says, we're still in very close contact with each other and didn't abandon it. I think they bought them. Just my opinion. With a single dev working on it fully functioning, yikes. I'd love to see Nathaniel's previous work if it exists. Nathaniel says, it's not a single dev working on it. Of course, I can't do this all by myself, and explained before, we're expanding the team with the most skilled developers. Well, how are you going to attach the tiles on the terrain? Nathaniel says, they are part of the terrain. Oh. I mean, is it easy to divide the terrain in trillions of squares? And Nathaniel said, yeah, that's solvable. Nice. I said, if you have the experience to build a physics engine from scratch that applies to a one-to-one scale of the entire world, I would love to see any prior work or experience. And it says, a physics engine is not needed for that. Physics is streamed, of course. What's needed is a custom terrain system, which I did make, which you can see in the E2 videos. Snap. That's literally him exporting Google Maps to Unity Engine that doesn't lead to making a physics engine. Then it says, how you think that Unity/Unreal Terrain can handle that? The terrain system I created is like Unreal 5 Nanite for terrains. Shots fired. E.g., check my Terrain Composer 2 Terrain Tool video. It was one of the first terrain tools to entire compute on the GPU with instant results. Also look at Ferran's Turbo Squid. Just don't call us noobs because we're not. E2 graphics will be like that. And Thanos says, similar and better. Those graphics were made 5 years ago, by the way. Oh, and again, they have mentioned and they have said that they will have... I'm going to talk to you guys down here. They will have graphics that are better than Red Dead Redemption 2. I wasn't calling you a noob. I was just asking for previous projects since I had some doubts, and they were provided. That's my bad. And it says, okay, sorry about that. No problem. Also, you can see us here, and he posts a YouTube link. Someone says, release a video of actual gameplay because right now it's literally begging people to cash in some tiles off Google Maps. LOL. Then it says, we're working on it. That's why we created the physics now, as it didn't have before. So I'm very curious to see what the physics are in there as well. Someone says, why is Shane never here? Then it says, Shane is all over the place expanding the company. A question for Wolfgang. When do you think there will be an official release regarding directions of gameplay mechanics? Specifically Phase 2. Not term 3D engine mechanics. Or not long-term 3D engine mechanics. Wolfgang says, the shapes of it will become visible with frequent updates over the next few months. We had to deal with a lot of technical and organizational debt from the wild early days. And now that I mentioned them, we're still in our early days, but now we are able to roll out our updates quicker and in a more organized and better tested way. So the relatively long, quiet phase will start to pay off pretty soon. I'm so excited reading this, which I haven't read this. Nathaniel, can you explain how the terrain engine works without explaining the details? Algorithms calculate the finer detail and level. Nathaniel says it basically works similar to Unreal 5 Nanny, with 31 different terrain mesh layers. Each layer is being streamed multi-threaded when moving from the HDD, CPU, GPU. It seamlessly updates without popping. It's incredible. Wolfgang, where you been? We missed you. You could give us a summary we'll be able to do in the game. Wolfgang says, working on designs, organization, other stuff that needed to get out of the way. All right, makes sense. Is Phase 2 on track for delivery in the first half of 2021? And if not, when will the website be updated? We're beyond the earliest possible point by now. Wolfgang says, you don't expect us to make any kind of announcement here, do you? We've learned from the beginnings. All right, so yeah, they're not going to announce anything. So that's fair, but we're less than 4 weeks out with no official launch date. It's not really a good look. Can't you guys see that? Wolfgang says, yes, we can, but we worked hard to get out of a machine that only piled on technical debt on the other. We are just now seeing the first fruits of that, and you can too. Customer service usually responds in less than 24 hours. The last release went without usual chaos. We will not give up the processes we all will benefit from for a low-hanging fruit again. Releasing something not thoroughly tested in an unorderly release process, that wouldn't help anyone. I'm talking about Dubai. You've been busy and may have missed some context. We're not asking for Phase 2 right now. We're asking for a realistic timeline of Phase 2 that we can stand by because the next 4 weeks aren't looking good. Wolfgang says, I understand that. You will get that timeline when we ourselves can be damn sure about it. Okay, so they don't want to make any false promises or say something, and then after they say that something, and then it doesn't come to pass, doesn't come to fruition. Question, I know you mentioned we'll be seeing fruitions of your team's work in the coming months. Is there a plan to reshape and improve messaging around vision of what you are moving towards as far as gameplay? It says, yes, messaging still needs a lot of improvement. Then again, I don't see a single field where we are not still a few miles away from even being good. On the other hand, if I look back at February, we are learning fast. So, could be a while. I still say Phase 2 is going to be by the end of the year, but they will not tell us. Nice. Can you tell us approximately about the date? I definitely hope 2022 will still be a while away before we roll them out. But development of such vast things are carrying their own surprises. And what that was is that was the follow-up question about messaging. That wasn't about Phase 2. That was just about messaging. Resource values. When? Thomas says, we cannot reveal those details yet. I'm sorry. So, hopefully soon. Wolfgang, as a member from the community begin to fill your ranks, are you still of the mindset that devs shouldn't own tiles as it may compromise design integrity? Wolfgang says, I still don't and won't, at least in any significant numbers. Maybe at some point I need to have some to see the game from an owner's perspective, but I would dedicate any financial benefits to charity, and I think that's how we should keep it. Yeah, I think so too. We're fighting to keep the good name of Earth 2 intact. The army against us seems to grow by the second. Thank you for jumping into the chat. Nathan says, thanks for that. With time, we will prove them wrong. Oh, this is a good one. Can I be poor in Earth 1, but rich in Earth 2? And Wolfgang says, if you are rich in Earth 2, you won't be poor in Earth 1, I hope. That is the biggest thing in the world right there, where he says, if you're rich in Earth 2, you won't be poor in Earth 1. That is one of the biggest things in the world. That, as far as the game goes, as far as I'm concerned, that is one of the biggest answers that we can get. So I can quit my day job at 10,000 tiles. Okay, says, you can quit your day job anytime. You just have to bear the consequences, no matter how many tiles you own in Earth 2. That's called freedom and responsibility. Two sides of the same coin. How will weather work? Daniel says, when it rains, you will get wet. I love him. Will the test country for resources be a test? Then after the test period, all gathered resources will be wiped for the start of Phase 2. Wolfgang says, after posting this question 10 times, at least without an answer, isn't that answer enough? they just didn't answer. When resources come out, do I need to build some sort of mining machine that mines? And will I need, for example, metal to build it and oil for it to run? Wolfgang says, you're Elon Musk, and you think we will repeat the same mistakes we are making on Earth 1? Oh, I guess Elon Musk answered that. So no, there's not going to be machines and there's not going to be oil. Very interesting. There's oil's a thing there. I guess oil's going to be used more for fire, or more for something else. I'm not sure, because oil's definitely a resource. Can you provide a ballpark of how large the team is now? The one in the E2 videos is a 30 by 30 kilometers and it can handle any size. Just doesn't have any data yet, but I made a test for the entire USA before 30 meter per pixel resolution. Before that, to testing streaming, 40 gigabytes of height map data compressed to 200 megabytes and can move around 80,000 kilometers per hour in that test. He's asking for the team. I think Nathaniel just answered a completely different one. It's funny. One thing, Wolfgang, that the critics have been harsh about is, what is the game? If you were to do your elevator pitch to answer this question, how would you? Wolfgang said, nice try. any hint for a lucky country? Wolfgang says, Sweden hasn't seen war since a few hundred years. That's lucky, I would say. Oh, all right. And what he was referencing, the lucky country, is which country is going to be the lucky one to get resources, you know, first. And then Wolfgang answered, like, well, Sweden is lucky. No war for 100 years or a couple hundred years. So just, he was just basically saying that in jest, being facetious. My question is how you will keep Earth 2 reputation intact. How on earth do you think you can ignore it and it will pass? Of course not. Videos like these multiply, YouTubers making them are increasingly bigger channels. Penguins, most recently, 10 million subs, 100,000 views in 2 hours. People keep ruining us. Fix it or Earth 2 will forever be a bad name. Who asked that question? Marco said, let's not panic. We're not ignoring this at all, but we can't knee-jerk a reaction out either. Good, good. Level heads prevail. Said, effing this up will just Streisand this out of proportion. Dreamworld caused some waves and the going got rough. Sure, but I'm a firm believer that clean delivery of content trumps any, trust me, bro. And he's 100% right. General Wolfgang comment, the economy will work based on, yes, work and community. Wow, okay, so the economy will be based on work and community. Trying to play it all by yourself will most probably not get the results you can achieve when cooperating. Firm believer that this world is no zero-sum game, and Earth 2 design will reflect this. Going any more into detail would be a violation of our internal announcements, only clause. So any question might be a clever sequence of words. It might even be entertaining, but it's otherwise futile. Wow, Wolfgang, going to the roof. Can you explain how your role might have transformed from when you first entered the scene? Are you still focused on just design, or has your responsibility increased? And if so, what extent? And Wolfgang says, my responsibility has always been more, as is natural in small but quickly growing company. Those with a lot of experience need to watch out for basically everything. We get more experienced people on board now, so I hope game design will get even more into focus in the future. Here's the thing, though. It would clean the E2 image. Wolfgang says, what will clean the E2 image is visible gameplay, and the investors will knock our doors down. All else seems upside down. So what he's saying is that, yeah, the best thing for Earth 2 is to have clean and visible gameplay. As soon as that happens, investors will be knocking down the door to try to get in. When is it likely, then? You are the designer, right? You have been very silent for over a month. Wolfgang says, for more than 2 months, actually. We are working hard to get it out as soon as possible, and we are working much more organized today so that once we are ready to go, we really are ready to go. someone just one stupid question. Have you seen big YouTubers are exposing this? I told people to sell. Not everyone's going to panic sell. The owner literally pays people to sit on Discord and make it seem like it's not a scam. No, they don't. Olga says, it'll be interesting to see whether and how they will retract and apologize. Looking forward to it. I, for myself, would like a good bottle of Glenmorangie Nectar d'Or as an apology. I will get that for him regardless, because I love the developers, everything that they do. Are my tiles good or bad? Yes or no? Wolfgang said, there are no bad tiles in Earth 2. That's interesting. What about some 83-cent tile in the middle of Chad, Africa? Wolfgang says, what if a certain resource becomes expensive in like 4 years from now that we buried there in the ground and hardly anywhere else? What I'm saying is, we have the tools in hand to balance that out. Oh, I love that. Talk dirty to me, Wolfgang. Sorry if that's a little NSFW. How would the devs respond to the valid points that the YouTubers make? One, I don't think they make valid points, but Wolfgang says why. They're making claims that we're a scam. We never claimed that this is a smooth rollout. We're always very open where things were. We survived a lot of things that would have killed other companies. I don't see any point in answering some stranger's unfounded claims. I'm confused if you're creating a metaverse or a game. Wolfgang says, is that an exclusive or a non-exclusive or? Oh, a metaverse game. Interesting. The hype era. At least it's coming back now, just with far more toxicity, unfortunately. Thomas says, we will keep working anyway. If we want to prove everyone what we can do, we will keep fighting. New project equals new challenges and new issues. If we will win, that's great. That's why we're here, right? To create something new. Agreed. They're pointing out specific reasons why there's suspicion. What do you think those reasons are? Do you think any of them are valid? Wolfgang says, yes, and all we can say is development like this takes time. We've been overrun by our unexpected success, and we survived it. Now it's time to get things on the road. If you don't believe us, fine. We never said anything else, and we have the reality to prove it. Oh, God, I can't wait. I don't know if we can believe the website, not whether it'll be updated by July 1st, that no premature announcements from any side. I don't know if the website was updated on July 1st or June 1st. If all tiles would produce resources, then what will be the use of Earth 1 mines? Okay, it says, a good market position for a special kind of resource. Buy the highlands. All right. Mountains? I think make it depend on class, not the amount of tiles. The more different mines you have, the better. I'm not sure what that person was trying to say, but Wolfgang says there'll be a lot of different influences. And somebody asked if you envision universities teaching virtual classes through E2, and Wolfgang says, actually, yes. What did I say? Oh, yeah. What are the most profound, prior to E2, are there any games projects you are most proud of that we should miss or that we should check out? Wolfgang says, check out Incubation, In Between, and The Void. I believe you said Phase 3 will be endless. Did you mean that because of vast diversity in biomes, it would take ages to cover it all, and that would be a gradual process covering them all? Wolfgang says that, and human evolution will never stop, at least not in my lifetime. I wonder if he's talking about AI, human merging with AI. When can we expect a playful part of Phase 2? Is the light version, if there will be one at all? And Wolfgang says, hopefully sometime before the year is over. So that's as close as we're going to get. Hopefully sometime before the year is over, we're going to get something with Phase 2. If y'all want people to believe in y'all so much, why don't you fix simple things and give more updates regularly like a great team does? Wolfgang says, because we're not yet a great team, but we're on the way to become one. Wow. That is powerful. And it says, general comment from Wolfgang, once we get our gameplay up and the general idea behind it becomes visible, I'm sure you will be asked to sell your tiles again, meaning that people will want to buy them. No, you need buyers, and no one can guarantee you buyers. Contrary to stock markets, where selling and buying shares is much faster. Wolfgang says, you still need buyers. Still a numbers game. Yeah, agreed. If Earth 2 is a game, what happens when all the tiles are sold? Because that will happen if this game gets big and nobody will buy all the water tiles. Wolfgang says people will buy water tiles when we give them reason to do it, and there are 5.1 trillion tiles out there. I don't see them being bought up anytime soon. I gotta get some water tiles. More water tiles. Would you put your mom and dad's life on the fact that this isn't a scam? I'm a big soul guy. I don't think you would lie on your mom. Wolfgang says, well, my dad died. Wolfgang's an older guy, guys. My dad died about 20 years ago, and I wouldn't put anybody's life on a bet before I bet on mine. Surely not my mom's. If that is a scam, it is the best hidden scam I ever saw. We are hiring people, expanding the cost, paying third party to up our game. Shane must be the worst scammer ever. Marco says, this is my first project in the industry. My face is out there. If it was, I'd be done for. Will players be able to moderate visitors on their own properties to an extent? Wolfgang said, sure. And other people said, I'm confused at how other people can build on your land. Like, what if someone builds a house on my land? What do? I need an explanation. And Wolfgang says, who said that was possible? I think what that comment was referring to was someone of the owner of the land renting out their land and then someone building the house on there. Because no one should build on your land without your consent. It shouldn't be possible. To hold hundreds of thousands of people playing in real time, I'm asking if servers can handle this volume. Wolfgang says, we think we know how to do this. Doesn't mean that's easy. How's the economic structure coming along? Wolfgang says, still a moving target, but it won't evade us forever. LinkedIn says there's 19 employees, and Wolfgang says, add to this a number of freelancers. Oh, that's interesting. This is the wrong attitude. You guys can mitigate players agreeing with these YouTubers by addressing issues some have raised, even if they are far-fetched. Long-term, less people will come into the project, and they will just have screenshots of this one, comment to make a point. Wolfgang says, what do you think I'm doing here since, 2 hours? I said, I don't care about the video and the guy who made it. I care about our users. And that pretty much means that Wolfgang was here just talking to everyone, kind of calming them down after the after those scam videos came out. Oh God, what's the next one? Your users have paid eye-watering sums for virtual land, which due to ever-increasing prices, they may never get that money back as they have to sell it on. Now confidence outside the Discord is extremely low. How would you feel if all holders are now stuck with useless virtual tiles? Your game developers will probably have no say on the economics, but the way this is structured means eventually people will lose money. It's inevitable. Wolfgang says, no, it's not inevitable. The bigger risk to the challenges of E2 are impatience and the destructive force of greed. And I agree with that 100%. Why would you buy something and then sell it at a loss? That is small finance energy right there. That is small money energy. And I feel like really only poor people without patience think like that. Believe in the long-term. One, don't put in a project that you think is going to fail. And then two, if you do, don't put any money in there that you're not willing to lose. Any investment ever. And that was it. All right, goodbye, guys. I got to go. Everyone comment, where's Dashy? Where is Dashy? We'll see you all later. All right, goodbye. Yeah.